The fifth of six children, Frederick C. Miller, was born in 1906 in Milwaukee into an entrepreneurial family. Young Miller was a natural athlete and academic standout. In 1928, while in college at Notre Dame, the All-American lineman helped to win one for the Gipper under the legendary Newt Rockne and was named captain of the football team in his senior year. He graduated cum laude and began working for his father at the Carl Miller Lumber Company. 8 years in this family business taught him valuable skills in management, especially during the years following the crash of Wall Street. Miller married, eventually fathering eight children, and furthered his career in the lumber industry until 1937, when at the young age of 31, he was named vice president of the other family business, Miller Brewing Company. Miller was every bit as compelling as his illustrious grandfather, who had started the company in 1855. Both would endure unimaginable growth and tragedy, with this third-generation golden boy bringing the family's brewing empire to new heights. In 1947, he became president and was given free rein in managing the company. Barely 2 months after he took office, Miller unveiled an ambitious 8-year plan to modernize the brewery and the campus we know today. He kept the company's rich history alive with his design of the Miller Inn. Additionally, he doubled the size of the brew house, raising the capacity from 2 to 4 million barrels per year. Miller developed a strong network of distributors and was soon serving all 50 states. With a foothold across the nation, he elevated Miller High Life from a regional favorite to a market mainstay. As most of their beer was now being sold in stores, Miller's advertisements began targeting female customers. Branding unveiled in the 50s had a distinctly upscale feel. Highlighting their slogan in use since 1907, the champagne of bottled beers was marketed as affordable luxury. Following the Korean War and a 2.5-month Milwaukee brewery workers' strike, Miller turned things around. Starting with company sponsorship of the 1949 radio favorite, The Lawrence Welk Show, he added TV, sports programming, point-of-purchase sales, and hired athletes during the off-season to promote his product. It was an eclectic mix of promotions and demand. By 1952, sales had increased an astonishing 379% at a time when the other local brewers posted a collective gain of less than 7%. Miller was realizing his vision to be the largest producer of the best beer. Passionate about sports and his community, he convinced the owner of the Boston Braves to relocate the team to Milwaukee and took a leading role in building two Milwaukee sports facilities, the Milwaukee Arena and County Stadium. He remained an important figure in local business and community affairs. One can only imagine the other accomplishments he would have achieved had his life not ended tragically in a plane crash that also took his son and heir apparent in 1954. Today, Miller Coors, a joint venture between SAB Miller PLC and Molson Coors Brewing Company, is the second largest beer company in America, capturing nearly 30% of U.S. beer sales. Miller Coors continues the commitment of Frederick C. Miller to brew the highest quality beers. In recognition of the third-generation brewer with a larger-than-life spirit and energy that propelled Miller Brewing Company from local brewery to international leader, we posthumously induct Frederick C. Miller into the Wisconsin Business Hall of Fame.